Now the nose, again, start by putting some light highlights on. They're not really white, they're more grey, but I'll start off with white. And again, the graphite is interfered with that slightly. I'm not worried about that. And another area here, which I should use my other, is there's a little bit of light there. Now, this doesn't show up very well, but we all know that it's there. That's on the end of the nostril. Okay, now this is a peculiar nose, I've got to say. And what I'm going to do here is I'm going to use another colour. And this is the 237 in Preta colour. Now, the reason I'm using that is the nose has got a lot of blue in it. Now, this might be peculiar to the photograph, I'm not sure. But I don't want to take a chance and not put it in. If you're following photographic reference, you've really got to be faithful to that. Ideally, you need a few references so that you can see. And I've got three references, in fact, here that I'm working on. And so I'm hoping between the three of them, I'm going to get this nose right. I've got to get it filled in and quite strong there with the colour. And then I'm going to use the colour shaper on it. I might use this one. The difference between the two is the other ones, the finer work. This one's more manly. Now that looks a bit weird, but I'm hoping that when I bring all the other colours in, that it won't look weird. Next colour. The colour which I haven't used yet is 181. So now I'm going to do my usual trick of going all the way around the outside edge of the nose, first of all. Peculiar. Now there's a nostril which is here. So let's put that in. In fact, I'm going to use the black as well for this. It doesn't matter which one. I think I'm going to use my Faber black because it's a little punchier than the Creta colour ivory black. Looking weirder and weirder, isn't it? Anyway, back in with 181. Now this has got to be just a general tone. All over, interfering with the white a little, except not on that edge. Well, it's looking a little better now. I'm going to try something now, which it's not easy on pastel mat, but I'm hoping that on the touch paper it's going to work, and it does. You can use the colour shaper on pastel mat, but it would have to have a lot more pastel on it. But this is working really well. So which gives it another quality, really. I mean, I love the ongre anyway, as you know. And I love the pastel mat. But this gives us, I think we're almost certainly going to be stocking it. Now you see, that's really blended really well. And by blending it well, it means we can come back with the other colours. And this time I'm going to switch back again to my ivory black. And this time I want to try to get some contour. Some of the light areas there I'm going to leave alone. So I'm really going in now with the deepest colour. There's also, as you already know, is a division there. And by advantage I've got by leaving, using two blacks, I can have one slightly more intense than the other. Now I'm being quite light here on the top of this one because I think I can put a bit of contour in. Deepen that, deepen that, deepen this side. Slightly interfere now with that white. Right, come back with the other black. You may not see too much of a difference, but there is. This black has got much more punch to it. Now I really have largely made this up because it's just a black blob on the photographic reference I've got. But it looks quite nice. Now I'm going back in with the first colour I use here, 237. What I'm hoping to do here is to use it a bit like a blender. Now I've lost the white, but I shall put that back again in a minute. Now you see how that's working? This is the importance of putting the white on. I've now picked that white up with the lighter tone of grey. Now that looks pretty good. Now what about this centre area? Just on both sides of that division. Very light touch. But we can put it in again, so let's do that. Now, I don't really think I can do very much more because I can't see anything else. But I like what I see. So now, with a little bit of white, but not as strong as it is on the highlight in the eye, we just put a little bit of that there and a little bit of that there. And maybe just a little spot there again. There you go, lovely. Well, I say lovely. Unfortunately, it looks as though it's stuck on. So what we've got to do now is work and the colours around. This is not easy, but how am I going to do this? I'll show you how it works. You've got to retain the shape of that, but you've got to make it look as though it's part of the same animal. So I'm darkening it slightly. there and there. Now, when it comes to the grey, I've got to put grey in. When I said grey, I meant white. And put the grey into the white so you pull it away. But really try to retain as much of that shape as you can. Kind of shaper might help here. With my white pencil, come into it again. Now that looks good. You see the difference between that and that? So let's go to the other side. It's right on the edge there, but gotta bring it in. And not just use that, but we can also use the other colours as well that I've got there. Now over this side it's slightly lighter simply because it's hitting the light source. So I can't make that as strong over there. And that can be shaper. Whiting. Well, there we are. Good. I'll probably touch that up again, but I can do that off camera. Now what I'm going to do now is to bring the mouth into play. Bit of black. Got the shaper. Little bit of white. There we are. Now that's pretty good. Pretty accurate to the picture I have. As I say, I'll just do a little bit of touching up, make it a little bit more realistic. But now what I'm going to do now is bring down the fur. And it's not quite so critical here, but let me show you how I'm going to start off. First of all, I'm going to do something different. This time I'm going to put in grey where we have the dark. I used a very dark grey before, but I think now I've got to be careful. So I'm going to put the grey in all the dark spots. Okay, so I'm going to do that. Once I've done that, I'm going to then bring the white back. Now, this is also going to be something that I can show you before I leave you. So that's going to be white. It's quite solid there. But we've got to separate that. Now, the way I do that, you've seen all this before, I know, but I'll show you again. You bring up a grey, and this time it can be 273, or I've just picked up this, which is very similar to 273. Then bring that out, and then you can use the colour shaper. Don't know whether I want it much darker than that. I think that might be dark enough. Maybe a little, just a spot darker. We don't want to make it look like a spot though. That's a spot. Put that in so it's a distinct difference between the two. This is the same colour, but I'm using it much lighter than that. And I'll do the same on the other side as well. Now, it looks a bit weird, but when we bring down the white, which I will do, a bit early to do it yet, but I'll show you how it's going to work anyway. I'm going to always do it again. You get that effect. And then here we have the white coming from there. So now we have the separation between the head and the body. Anyway, I can get on with that now. And that's also going to be similar to fur up here, where we'll be using some white and some of the 187. So let me get on with that. But the first thing I've got to do is I've got to put all of the dark colours in, and I'm going to use this 273 for that.